And so I was kind of anxious about getting there, because I'm sure there was a mass that I was supposed to get to right before that, or right after that. And so, but the guy kept talking. And I got the impression as I was talking with him, you know, that he would really like me to do what he thought the church does on such a question like this. Shut up, you know, you're wrong. Stop living that way, you're gonna go to hell and bye. I got this sense that, you know, he was expecting that. I thought to myself, that is not gonna be how I live. I am gonna listen. He's gonna end the conversation, not me. I don't want him to say, he turned me down, he shut me off. He wouldn't listen. And went on. And then finally, he said this, Father, I'm not interested in the sex of these relationships. I don't want to die alone. Man, what is insight he gave me? He gave himself. He sees himself. And you know, the thing about it is, if he lives chastely and doesn't go down the marriage route, he can live with anybody he wants. And he can have the protection of the law in most of his legal matters. And he can live in union with God too, and share his life which comes to him through the Eucharist, through the teachings of the church, and through the sacraments, our prayer together. Am I ever glad I didn't hang up on him? I would have missed his cry for help. I would have missed hearing what really burdened his heart. And the opportunity to tell him that he belongs even though he suffers. That he is well in his journey to the cross. This is how the church can help. We can listen. We can hold the teachings. Sacred scripture and tradition, and we can help people to share what's on their heart and assure them that if they will follow Jesus' teaching, they can walk their suffering and triumph in it. No one has to die alone. We only have to die in the arms of Jesus. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our Savior was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The world was created by the Word of God, recreated by His redemption, and continuously renewed by His love. Rejoicing in Him, we call on.
Through your Son, the herald of reconciliation, the victor of the cross, free us from empty fear and helplessness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep our farmers safe during the harvest, and fill our hearts with gratitude for your bountiful care for us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Touch with wonder and love the children of our parish, who will receive their first communion on Sunday, and help us welcome them to the table of the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. Heal our church, and help us proclaim the truth with mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bless our country, and help us overcome the division and strife that is present among us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant our sick the consolation of your presence, and our faithful departed a place in your kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty ever living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity. Make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. I'd like to sing number 661 in our songbook for the altar again. Number 661.
Wherever you go, I will go. Wherever you live, so shall I live. Your people will be my people, and your God will be my God too.
Wonder to rule in your name over all you have made, and for forever praise you in your mighty works, in Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels, we praise you as a joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and James our Bishop and all clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord. should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Amen.
St. Michael, your archangel.
Israel.
Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. And we'll close with America the Beautiful, number 731. America the Beautiful.
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of rain, for purple mountain majesty, above the fruited plain, America, America, God shed his grace on thee, and grant thy goodly brother from sea to shine.